Wow, is this a cast too? What the?
Hello, this is Chun. We are
Raccoon. I'm sharing a way to improve the quality of the ENG by simply changing the settings.
Wait, can a device that's been out for over 2 years really improve even more?
Perhaps it's not that. Rather, maybe Meta isn't optimizing properly.
Well,
applying it is pretty simple, but it's crucial to grasp the principle and give it a shot. As the best value can differ depending on your specific network situation and other factors. It's a tuning technique that may not work for everyone. So, let's first discuss the codecs that are key to this optimization. We'll take a look at how it works and get into a detailed comparison. Okay, let's get into it. Both the ENG and wired link work by sending compressed videos with some loss from the original source to your device. This basically means that they compress the video by sacrificing some quality to reduce the size. In the cast, you can choose between two compression methods, H.264 and H.265. And the default option for the wired link is H.264, while for the ENG it's H.265.
Nah, this is hard right off the bat.
Don't worry, it's not hard. Let me take it one step at a time. H.265, also called HEVC, is a newer video codec than H.264. It's called High Efficiency Video Codec. It can show the same quality video as H.264, but with smaller sizes, which means you can save up to 50% on sizes. This is especially true for high-resolution videos. Maybe that's why ENG didn't choose H.265 as their default codec. But nothing comes for free in this world. This high efficiency compression means that it can be difficult to decompress. In fact, it could require up to 10 times more computing power than H.264 to decode and play the video. It has advantages in terms of network because it's less sizes, but it also means that you will need a more high-spec processor. The processor in the cast 2 is called the XR2 and it's a mobile chipset. Since it's designed for mobile use, it's not super powerful. ENG's max bit rate maximum data transfer per second is 200 Mbps. This number seems to be a limit of the Cat2's XR chip when it's decoding H.265 rather than a limit of the network itself. So, even if your network can handle more than 200 Mbps, you might have trouble playing games if you go above that number because the XR2 chip struggles to decode H.265 at higher bitrate. For wired link, unlike ENG, the default codec is H.264. Also, there's no menu to set the max bitrate on wired link, but you can do it using the Oculus debugging tool. Most reviews suggest that wired link can be set to around 400 to 500 Mbps. The bitrate default for the wired link was 200 Mbps for me. Perhaps Meta should have considered the following. For wired, network bandwidth is reliable, so choose H.264, which can be decoded with a higher bitrate. ENG seems to have chosen H.265 as a good option for maintaining video quality even with a weaker network connection. They must have assumed that users don't have great network. The important thing here is if we have enough network bandwidth. ENG communicates directly between PC and cast devices on the internal network without going through the internet. So, as long as your router is good enough to handle it, you won't have any problems with bandwidth.
It's just so complicated.
You are so close. Just hold on a little bit longer. To sum up, ENG compresses your PC gameplay and sends it over the router to your cast 2. There are two ways to compress the video, H.264 and H.265. H.264 is a bit less compressed, resulting in larger video sizes, but it's easier to process. H.265 is more compressed, resulting in a smaller video size, but requires more computing power. Data transfer between the PC and Cast 2 is based on your router's specs, regardless of your internet network. Therefore, if your router has the right specs, you can set up Cast 2 to handle high data transfer rates.
Alright, so what kind of router do we need? Well, we can just make it to match the specs of the KOR CC, since that's what's receiving and processing data. The KOR CC works with Wi-Fi 6, so as long as the router supports Wi-Fi 6, we are good to go. Just make sure the router is labeled as supporting Wi-Fi 6 and IEEE 802.11ax or higher. IEEE stands for Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, and the number 802 comes from February 1980. That's when the folks at IEEE got together to talk about making a standard for a local area network, LAN. As time went on, they ended up coming up with a whole bunch of other standards too. One of those was for wireless networking, which we all know as 802.11. And the technology we implemented based on this standard is Wi-Fi.
Hey, it's making me dizzy. Just give it to me.
Please watch your little more. KOR CC supports Wi-Fi 6, which means that any Wi-Fi 6 router that supports 802.11ax or higher will get the most out of KOR CC. If you have a Wi-Fi 6 router, the internal network speed test usually measures around 900 Mbps. So a bitrate of 400 Mbps or more isn't a big problem. There are various ways to test your internal network, but for me, I installed the APK of an Android app called Wi-Fi Speed Test on my KOR CC and tested it that way. If you have a router that supports AX, but the internet network speed is slow, check whether you are using the 5 GHz frequency band instead of 2.4 GHz, or whether you are assigned to an empty channel, and whether there are other devices connected to the Wi-Fi that could be affecting the network speed. Have you been following along so far? So, the conclusion is that the limit for H.265 is 200 Mbps. But if you are using H.264 and your router can support it, you can set it to 400 Mbps. It's a showdown between H.265 200 Mbps and H.264 400 Mbps. The question is whether you should use the next generation codec with a lower bitrate or simply increase the bitrate manually. Let's take a closer look. In conclusion, increasing the bitrate results in better video quality. The advantage of H.265 is that it takes up less size than the same image quality. But when it comes to image quality, it's best to increase the bitrate to H.264. Therefore, setting up a stable bandwidth environment and adjusting the maximum bitrate to 400 Mbps, which does not cause decoding problems with H.264, is the best way to experience high-quality video. The 400 Mbps figure may vary depending on factors such as PC specs, routers, channels, and room layout. In my case, I experienced stuttering when I set it to 500 and I didn't notice a significant difference between 400 and 500. So I found 400 to be the optimal value. It's best to initial test with 500 and gradually lower it if there are problems to find the optimal value that works for you. You've been waiting for a long time, but now I'm finally gonna show you how to change in the setting. You could modify the Windows registry, but that's a hassle, so I made a simple program. I'll add the download link in the description. It's an executable file that doesn't require installation, so once you download it, you will see this screen. If you wanna change the ENG codec setting to H.264, just click the HEVC off button here. To make sure it's working right, click the perp HUD button and you will see a window on the HND screen with all the performance stuff, including the codec and bitrate. Now just testing it out by putting the bitrate from 500 and down. Enter the values in the input box and hit enter or click somewhere else. The HVC up only works before you connect ENG, and the bitrate changes in real time as soon as you do it. In case you are unsure if this method works, try switching the bitrate between 100 and 400 to compare the image quality and see the difference in compression artifacts. Once you've found a setting that works smoothly higher than 200 Mbps, then you are all set. Congratulations! Today, we learned how to optimize the video quality of ENG by tuning the codec and bitrate values. I think that Meta might have set the default values for users who have routers don't support Wi-Fi 6. Therefore, I have shared a great tip that can be applied immediately if you have a reasonable good router. I hope everyone can enjoy the maximum video quality of ENG with this tip before the release of KOR CC 3. While making the video, a thought came to mind. Although the Cast Pro was set to support Wi-Fi 6E earlier this year, Wi-Fi 6E routers are expensive and have less merit compared to the soon-to-be-released Wi-Fi 7. So I became curious about a dedicated router using the PCIe card of the Intel AX210 chip on my PC. So that's why. I'll test it in the next video and share it. By the way, the KOR CC Pro's local dimming feature was recently updated to version 51. I'll compare the KOR CC Pro's local dimming on-off and pixel dimming with the Pulsebear 2 OLED display, which doesn't need local dimming. I have a lot of video production promises to keep, but I just don't have enough time to make them all. Nonetheless, I'll work hard to keep those promises. That's all for today's video. Please don't forget to subscribe and like. Thank you!